gentlemen, it's Charlie Fibrosis, and well, let's show you something. We're just doing this for fun. So, we're playing NASCAR Thunder 2003. We're doing the 2002 season mode. We have run 36 races. 3 races have been set to 10%. And this has been our season so far. Running as Dale Earnhardt Jr. has been a season of domination. So, we won the Daytona 500. Won the Subway 400 in North Carolina. Atlanta. Darlington. Bristol. Texas. Martinsville. Talladega. California. Richmond. Lost on the All-Star. Won the Coke 600. Had DNF at Dover, finished top 10 at Pocono, won at Michigan, DNF'd at Infineon, won at Daytona, finished runner-up to Dale Jarrett at Chicagoland, finished 39th, I think, at New Hampshire, won at Pocono, won at Indy, DNF'd at the Glen, won at Michigan, won at Bristol, won at Darlington, won at Richmond, won at New Hampshire, DNF'd at Dover, went back, won at Kansas, won at Talladega. I think we DNF'd at Charlotte for the fall race, won at Martinsville, won at Atlanta, won at North Carolina, and then we had a DNF at Phoenix. It hasn't been the perfect season, but it's been amazingly good. We have led the point standings from race one all the way to the end. 655 point gap between us and Dale Jarrett. And $13 million in the bank. Definitely different. And fifth place on up. Less than 1,000 points of play. Sixth place on back, by 1,000 points out of it. We've done it. So, let's show you the starts and stats and everything. We have had 35 starts, 30 poles, 25 wins, 27 top 10s, top 5s, 29 top 10s, an average start of 2.9. The average finish of 8.7, best finish first, 678 laps led. But to compare that, Jeff Gordon is behind us in second with only 60 laps led the whole entire season. Fastest top speed the entire season long. We have not been as consistent because of this DNF. Cody Stewart is the only driver that's ran every single lap. We haven't done two. Like I said, we've had some DNF. Two laps and we'll break 1,000 for the season. And then just a lot of extra money in terms of weekly awards. So, all awards, front runners, fast pace, move of the race. I think if we go back. New Hampshire, we didn't get anything. Finneon, we didn't get anything. Martinsville. I'm surprised we didn't get anything for that, but we ended up winning. In all the places, we had a case where the, didn't get additional bonus. Okay, here we go. Lap champion for laps led. Yep, that's right there. Debbie's run away with the Factors Championship. Jackpot 5, we won $3 million in that, so. Yeah. And, best finish was Shane Hawley, and that's actually impressive because at one point Gary Nadeau, his best finish was, I believe, dude got it. Gary, at one point, his best finish all season long was 15. So everyone has managed to have at least actually a decent season. It's just that we led so many laps and won so many races. So if we look at it one more time on the driver stats. I mean, yeah, if we look at it like we are on the way to win the championship. And that's that. And the hilarious thing is we're well over Dale Earnhardt Jr.'s actual career victories. If we win one more race, if we win the Homestead Valley, he will tie in wins all career long with Dale Earnhardt in just one race. Alright, so it doesn't even matter where we finish, to be honest. We're just doing this for fun. We're going to race at old flat Homestead. We're going to get a good setup in there. We're going to have fun. If we crash, we crash. We win.
Welcome to the Homestead Miami Speedway for today's NASCAR Winston Cup race, the Homestead 400. Barney, with this being a fairly new racetrack, these drivers don't have the notes to look back on like they do at other racetracks. What do you think we'll see in this one?
This is a wide, flat track. The lack of banking in the turns keeps the speeds down and usually makes for a lot of green flag racing. I don't expect to see too many caution flags.
Dale Earnhardt Jr. has an impressive average finish this year.
Man, he is amazing. And what a boost towards the championship that gives him. You don't even need that many wins if you're finishing in the top 10 every week.
Bill Elliott owned and drove for his own race team for 6 years before joining Ray Evernham in 2001.
You know, driving for your own race team is a tough deal. I think Bill was happy to get back to worrying about one thing, being fast out there on the racetrack.
Frank Kimmel hasn't performed well at the Speedway tracks this season.
Well, his crew chief assured me this morning that they've got a fast car. Let's keep an eye on him and see how it goes.
Thank you.
Barnhart Jr., the NASCAR Winston Cup points leader, will be starting for the pole. In the second row are the...
Get ready. Green, green, green.
Thank you.
flying out there, buddy. Good job.
Thank you.
lead changes were pretty scarce.
Well, to be honest, Joe, I'm a little surprised that we didn't have more leaders. Just goes to show that with the right setup and the right strategy, you really can dominate a NASCAR Winston Cup race.
Dale Earnhardt Jr. ran in clean air pretty much all race long.
Doesn't get much better than that. He led the most laps, and more importantly, he led the last lap, which gives him the victory.
We hope you enjoyed today's race as much as we enjoyed bringing it to you. Until next time, this is Joe Moore and Barney Hall signing off.
Wow.
And that is the season, ladies and gentlemen. What a run. Stats and info. Championship lead of 680. And only the top five were within our at 1,000 points or less. 13.6 million dollars. 31 points. 26. 28, 30 top 10s, an average time of 2.8, and an average finish of 8.8. Jane Hall still with the best finish in 10th. 710 laps led on. Still the fastest car. It managed to break into the 1,000 category, which means Mark Martin with the least laps out of anyone. Jeff Gordon, Mark Gordon, Kevin Harvick, Jimmy Spencer, and Elliott Sadler got points this season. And well over a 100 point gap between Chevy and Ford. Guys, that's going to wrap it up here. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you again.